Hey there, everybody. It's Chris and Kelly from the Holmquist Group, Keller Williams Metropolitan Realty. How are you today?
I'm good. Today we are going to talk about multiple offers from a buyer's perspective and a seller's perspective. The reason being that every new listing that comes on the market seems to have
30 showings, 40
yeah,
showings.
20, 30, 40 showings because there are so many buyers who want to purchase and so few sellers on the market right now.
Right, so we're gonna handle this from the buyer's perspective and the seller's perspective. I'm gonna run down kind of some of the key factors that buyers can do to give themselves the best opportunity, and Kelly's gonna talk about how sellers are making that final decision on which offer to choose. So getting right into it, first and foremost, you really need to go with experience, right? You wanna have a realtor who is knowledgeable, who has a good reputation in the market, who can guide their clients through this difficult process that is called the multiple offer. And once you have aligned yourself with somebody like that, it really comes down to starting with a buyer consultation. I sit down and have conversations with virtually every single client that I have to prepare them for what's going on in the market, mm-hmm. talking about the inventory, talking about what's gonna happen once they find the right property, making sure that they are gonna be pre-approved with the right lender, right? That's mm-hmm. gonna be a big one. You'll talk about that in a second. You know, what is their financial situation? What kind of a down payment are they looking to do? What's important for them in a home? Are they handy? Can they waive some of their inspection items that might come mm-hmm. up in an inspection? Mm-hmm. We also talk about the appraisal process and how that goes down. And then Kelly will talk about how that factors into the offers as well. So all of that happens before we even go out and take a look at a single home. That way, once we do find the right house, we are able to move quickly and with confidence. Mm-hmm. And I think that that's a key element as well. The clients I represent are not, you know, wishy-washy. They are not going to sit there and be like, oh my God, are we doing the right thing? Or how is this going to work? Because we've already covered all of that
right
in the buyer consultation.
And that's unfortunately when that's not done, when buyers have not been counseled before they go out to see homes, that's when we see cold feet set in after a buyer has made an offer and now they've had a chance to think about it because they had to act quickly to get that offer in to be considered. We don't want that happening 2 or 3 days after an offer is presented, especially if their offer has been accepted.
Right. So once we do that, we're going to put all that stuff together. We're going to put an offer in. It's going to be nice and neat. It's going to be a nice package to send to the listing agent. And as crazy as that sounds, that is also a key component of our offer, is that every offer goes in as one PDF format document, so that it's easy for the listing agent to go through to see that we have a copy of the MLS sheet, a copy of the pre-approval, a copy of the signed seller disclosure, any other disclosures that need to go along with it.
A complete offer package goes a long way. From a seller's perspective, what we're looking at, that we're evaluating when we have multiple offers, typically I'll put those in a spreadsheet to look at all of the black and white items. For example, what is the offer price? How much is the down payment? How much is the mortgage amount? What type of mortgage is it? What is the closing date that's being proposed? And any other notes? Are they willing to waive the appraisal? Have they given a minimum price if the house doesn't appraise? Are they waiving home inspections? Are they just limiting those to safety and structural items? So all of those things are evaluated, but that initial offer package that comes from the agent tells me whether or not that agent is prepared, if they have a handle on the situation, typically
organized.
Typically it comes across, you know, when I find out from that agent, you know, these people have been looking for a long time, or these people are ready to go, they have their pre-approval. All of those things come into play because the stronger that offer is, whether it's the price and the terms and the agent, because I'm looking for an experienced agent who I know is going to see this through to the end, as well as a prepared, thorough, organized packet, all of those things come into play, especially if you have offers that are very similar on paper. The agent can carry a lot of weight in terms of their experience level and how much they have their act together.
So bottom line, it's not just a matter of price for
yourself.
It's
never just price.
There's a lot of components, as you heard, that go into an offer. There's a lot of components that go into creating the offer. There's a lot of components that go into the sellers making a decision on which offer to take and which one's the strongest.
And so some of it is agent intuition. Not, I wouldn't even say intuition, it's experience. We've both been through the 2000 to 2006 market when we saw a similar situation, not exactly like the one that we're in right now, but we know what we're looking for in terms of strength of the offer and which one do we see going through to the end based on the experience that we have. Another thing that I wanted to mention was, you know, we talked about mortgage type, but also the lender. As the market, as we get further on in this market, we're seeing more and more mortgage brokers come into the market that either have no reputation or a bad reputation, and we try to avoid them as well.
Absolutely, because that's a huge component of the deals going through. So here we go. Experience, knowledge, reputation in the marketplace, buyer consultations ahead of time, and I know that you have the seller consultation really ahead
Absolutely.
Of time
and,
as well.
And strategizing with the sellers. How are we going to get the highest price for the house with the best terms and walking them through the process of making sure that we select the right offer.
Right. So if you are thinking about selling your house, contact this one. If you're looking to buy a house, contact this one. Hit us up with a personal message and we're happy to help out. Our team, we helped 150 families find homes last year and we're ready to go.
Ready and raring to go this year.
Sounds great.
Thanks.
Bye.